Absolutely. Man walked this earth and did miracles and died. That's the Son of God, as resurrected, right? So we now see him through this resurrection as the Son of God. Does anybody want to try these? Are you all distracted? Anyone want to try to see what they feel like? Right? Jack, you can try one. Come here, Liz. I like you. You're like old school. Like the way they look. You're cool. You can't take anyone, anyway. I should put them on my shoulders. Well, I just let them in my I did. I put them on my shoulders a little bit, but now they're in my hand. Like this? Kind of thing? Yeah. But these are not the kind of ways to go on your shoulders. These are the kind of ways to put the hand, right? These different kinds of things. There's lots of muscle you guys here. You guys know different ways to do this, right? So that's good. And these things, I'm not doing any of them if I do like this. Right? With these things. But they belong in my hand, right? They belong in my hand. And so, as we look at Christ in a different way, we also look at each other in a different way. Look at what this says in it. This says that we see each other because there's a new creation. We don't look at Christ in the same way anymore. We also don't look at us. Each other in the same way anymore. This is part of that reconciliation that we talked about, the work of Christ accomplished. There is a purely human way to see each other, and it's usually based on yourself. I am not like you, you are not like me. It's self-referential. It's a self way to look at somebody else and look at yourself. I am not like you, you are not like me. Now, if it stays in that purely human way to look at each other, we start with, I am not like you, you're better. I need to get better. You are not like me, I'm better than you. You need to get better. See, but this is not kingdom perspective. The kingdom perspective says, I am not like you, you are not like me. We are both created in the image of God, and these are. Woo-hoo. It's a different way of looking. It doesn't wipe out. It doesn't say we're all just equal and the same. It says we are all unique and made in the image of God. It's a cool thing. It's different. Right? I am not like you. You are not like me. Thank God. Because then that next step is, I like you. It's a cool thing to be able to say, I like you. I mean, just me, and I like you. And that starts from God. God likes me. I know that. I like you. God likes me. I like God. You're made in the image of God. I like you. It's the starting point for this ministry of reconciliation. How can we say that? Because of how God sees us. See, those weights that were on our shoulders and were on our backs that Rachel has prayed for, they are gone because of the work of Jesus Christ. We pray for them to fall off, and that's what they're talking about here. When he says this, we are no longer seeing him in that way, in that purely human way, because he now no longer sees us in that way. If anyone is in Christ, she is a new creation. It's this justification is the starting point of it. I know it's a big word, justification. What does it mean? Come on, interns. What does justification mean?
To be made right with God.
To be made right with God. It's a legal term. Permitted to be declared right with God. To be in right relationship. It's a permanent legal standing. Where does it come from? In this passage, where does it come from? If anyone is in Christ. That's it. He did the work. That's done. That permanent legal standing. And the way that God sees us in Christ. It's part of that salvation in Christ. And so we pray, yeah, drop off that weight. Whenever we feel like we have this weight on our shoulders or our back, we pray, drop the weight, pick up the cross. Drop the weight, pick up the cross. Justification. Done one time in Jesus Christ. We celebrated this weekend. It was done on Good Friday. Atonement for all sin. Done. All you have to do is say, I am in Christ. He was put to death for my sin. And it's done. But then, he's not done with us. See, the baton has passed. Everything is from God who reconciled us to himself through Christ and gave us the ministry of reconciliation. That is, in Christ, God was reconciling the world to himself, not counting their trespasses against him. And he has committed the message of reconciliation to us. What in the world is reconciliation? It says it over and over and over again. What's reconciliation? Restoration of what? Relationships. Relationships. It's the work of making relationships right. Our starting point is seeing each other in a different way. When God sees us, we now see each other with those eyes. Reconciliation. The work of making relationships right. Jesus. It's this baton. It's been passed to us. The work that he did, making relationships right, it's been passed on. It says it's been committed to us. That's like a definite here. This baton is right here. Right? I'm really impressed when I did that. Ambassadors for Christ. No, it says, therefore, time on our hands, we are ambassadors for Christ. No. Therefore, we are ambassadors for Christ. Certain that God is appealing through us. We plead on Christ's behalf. Be reconciled to God. He made the one who did not know sin to be sin for us so that we might become the righteousness of God in him. Therefore, that therefore at the beginning is huge. Therefore, I know Jesus Christ as my Lord and Savior. Therefore. I know Jesus Christ as my Lord and Savior. Therefore, I am an ambassador for Christ. Therefore, I am certain God is appealing for me. You feel the weight of that baton yet? If you know Jesus Christ, you are an ambassador for Christ. If you know Jesus Christ, you can be certain God is appealing through you to this world, to your friends. God is appealing to us. See, God put the wrong on him who never did anything wrong so that we could be put right with God. So that we could be free to be ambassadors for Christ. So we have to ask, why aren't we appealing for God? Why haven't we picked up the cross? I'm not lacking anything. Why haven't we?
Me with weights or God with me?
You can't take the baton if you're holding on to weights. Rachel talked about guarding our mind. Make our thoughts obedient to Christ. Instead of working out like this, make our thoughts obedient to Christ. We start to embrace for the sake of Christ that I am content with weakness, insult, hardship, persecution, calamity. For when I am weak, then I am strong. Philippians 4:8. Finally, whatever is true, whatever is honorable, whatever is just, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is commendable, if there is any moral excellence, if there is any praise, dwell on these things. Here's the cool thing. Jesus is all of these things. I am in Christ. It says that I have put on righteousness in Him. So, if I am in Christ, God sees me as moral. God sees me as commendable. God sees me as lovely. God sees me as pure. God sees me as just, honorable, and true. I am the person God has attached to the throne. If you know Jesus Christ, you are the person He has attached to the throne of the Father. He passed it on. He committed it to you. It's there on the floor. God does not call a qualified to qualify the call. No, wait! I'm crazy. No, wait! I'm not good enough. No, wait! I need to find a girlfriend first. No, wait! I don't have time. No, wait! I do the right things don't always come out of my mouth. No, wait! I'm not sure if I'm doing the right thing all the time. No, wait! I did something wrong last night. No, wait! No, wait! No, wait! No, wait! The world is waiting for the Son of God to be released. And we come up with every weight we can imagine. Every day. We pick up a weight every time we go to meet with our friends. We pick up a weight every time there's an opportunity to share about Jesus. And we feel that we're not free. We pick up a weight, and all that was in this passage was being in Christ. That's the only qualification. Drop the weight. In Christ, God sees you as a human. God sees you as trustworthy. God sees you as powerful. And so, be encouraged. Now, at this time, in the middle of the word, do this. Can you see how foolish everybody is? Now, that's so mean. The one who washes your feet, the one who died for your sins, says, I commit this to you. There are people all over who need the ministry of restoration. Who need restoration. Look at my eyes right now. I like you. Anybody not believe that? We're going to have to be kind of this. I know Jesus. He loves you. God doesn't just love you, He loves you. He knows you just the way you are. In Christ, we are in Christ, God sees you as true, as honorable, as just, as pure, as lovely, as commendable, as morally excellent. You are family. We are brothers and sisters. The work that before us is not judged. The work that before us is to build relationships. We believe at Generation Church to be examples to all believers. Now, lead this church, I'm talking Christ Church, lead this church, I'm talking Generation Church, lead. We talked about these guys up here, we spoke into them. I'm doing a love chair for the whole group right now. What this passage says is that in Christ, the baton will be passed to you. God, we thank you for the work that you have done. Lord, that you wash us clean. Lord, that you were resurrected so that we can have hope, purpose, and life in abundance. Lord God, will you be with us in strength as we operate in your ministry and pass on to us the ministry of reconciliation. Lord, show us the people in our lives who need thank you. You are a partner.